Hi, this is Reese Davis from ESPN's College Game Day. You're watching the Alligator Sports Video Show. Adventure into the swamp. Only gators get out of line.
Adam Bear here with a little recruiting news for you. This was a familiar sight across the country Wednesday as it was National Signing Day, the first chance for high school commits to sign their national letters of intent with their respective schools. Florida coach Will Muschamp picked up 18 recruits on National Signing Day, his first recruiting class. Here you can see one of those commits, Juwan Story, a wide receiver out of Brooksville Nature Coast, who chose the Gators over the Ohio State Buckeyes as he sat down to sign his letter of intent. Story committed to UF in June 2010, flirted with the idea of Oregon, and told us just how close he was to being a Buckeye.
Yeah, I have no idea. Just like 20 minutes ago, I was talking about going there.
He's left an impression on me. We talked last night for hours outside. He couldn't sleep, I couldn't sleep, so we just out in the driveway talking about everything. And I have 17 nieces and nephews. Juwan is near and dear to my heart. He's like a son to me. And people say that I help him, but he's helped me. He's made it easy for me to care for him.
Tom Green here. Let's take a look at some of the key signings of Will Muschamp's first class. His biggest victory was getting 7 of the players enrolled in classes for a spring. Most importantly, Jeff Driscoll. Muschamp said there's an open competition at every position, including quarterback. UF landed a few weapons on offense, including running back Mike Blakely, wide receiver Javaris McCroy, and tight end A.C. Leonard. They got 2 offensive linemen in Tommy Jordan, who enrolled early before deciding to return home for the semester, and Tripp Thurman. They also inked an impressive haul of 6 DBs, including Luchez Purifoy, who people didn't know much about until he got offers from UF and Alabama. They also landed Marcus Roberson, who was committed to both Auburn and Texas Tech, and Jabari Gorman. The Gators added a 19th commitment 2 days after National Signing Day when Dwyer quarterback Jacoby Brissett announced at his basketball game that he would attend UF over Miami and Wisconsin.
Next year I'll be playing at the University of Florida.
Brissett's mom wanted him to go to UM and wasn't pleased with his decision. She would try to change his mind before he sends in his letter of intent on Monday.
Adam Berry and Greg Luca here talking a little Florida basketball. The Gators are coming off a huge week of Southeastern Conference play. Picked up a 70-68 win over Kentucky Saturday night in the O'Connell Center. That was coming on the heels of a 65-61 win at home against Vanderbilt on Tuesday.
These are huge wins for the Florida team. Kentucky and Vanderbilt are perennially at the top of the SEC East, and those are two teams Florida went 0-4 against last season.
It's huge. They're both very good teams. They're both well coached. They're both very good teams. To get those 2 wins on our side of the SEC East is huge.
It was an especially big week for Parsons as the senior forward posted a 17-point, 12-rebound, 5-assist performance against Kentucky with no turnovers. That was on the heels of an 18-point, 11-rebound game against Vanderbilt.
The senior has 5 consecutive games with double-digit rebounds and has really stepped up his play since the loss to Jacksonville, and particularly since SEC play got underway.
Parsons was a force to be reckoned with on the offensive glass as well. Here's one of his 2 putback dunks, and he also had a later putback and 1 layup.
Parsons' 5 assists were part of the team's stellar ball movement on the game, which you can see here resulting in an easy dunk for freshman Patrick Young.
Young wasn't the only beneficiary of this excellent ball movement, though, as Alex Tyus rebounded from a pretty weak first half to score 6 early points in the second half, due largely to the team's inside and outside passing. And, Tyus also did all this while guarding Kentucky's star forward Terrence Jones, who you can see him packing one of his shots. He was tasked with guarding him most of the night, while point guard Irving Walker was tasked with guarding Kentucky star freshman Brandon Knight.
Knight and Jones basically took over the Kentucky offense in the second half. Very often Kentucky isolated the left side of the court from them, where they basically played 2-on-2 against Walker and Young. That strategy yielded some mixed results, but it usually worked out pretty well for the Wildcats.
Knight finished with 24 points, just 1 shy of his season high on 7-of-14 shooting, including 4-of-5 from 3-point range. Jones added 18 points in 38 minutes. That's a game high, 1 more than Chandler Parsons, who impressively played all 20 minutes of the second half. It was the only player Billy Donovan could remember doing that in his time here. Despite Parsons' impressive game, he was still Kentucky's go-to guy when it came time to foul late in the game. Parsons hit one of two free throws with about 13 seconds left, and Kentucky went immediately to freshman guard Brandon Knight, who came down, guarded by Boynton, came off a screen and launched up this three, which fell just short, allowing the Gators to escape with a two-point victory. But Billy Donovan said the most important thing now is not letting it get to their heads.
But when our guys get knocked down, they usually try to get back up and they try to fight. It's when we have these moments that they want to go, okay, and we cannot do that right now. Okay, that's the worst thing that we can do. And I talked to him about it in the locker room after the game was over with, about we have a great opportunity to make an incredible growth and step as a team going forward from this game.
With the wins over Kentucky and Vanderbilt, Florida now sits alone atop the SEC East with a 7-2 record. They will look to extend that lead as they head to Columbia, South Carolina on Wednesday to take on the Gamecocks.
After that, they'll be back here in Gainesville to take on Tennessee Saturday night at 6. That game will be important because Tennessee currently sits second in the SEC standings at 5-3. A win for Florida will give them an even bigger lead in the division.